afternoon and welcome to the Northampton College virtual event for construction. My name is Phil O'Hara, I'm Vice Principal for Curriculum and Student Progress at the College, and we're absolutely delighted that you're able to join us today for this event. Before we get going, I think it's probably just worthwhile me just running through how it'll work for the next 45 minutes, an hour or so. So in a moment, you're going to get a short presentation from our principal, Pat Brennan Barrett, and our deputy principal, Patrick Levy. And they're going to give us a bit of an overview of the college and an update on the current situation. Then you'll hear from our expert panelists that are with us today, and they'll be talking you through opportunities at the college, so the types of courses that we offer. And the various different levels of programme. What it's like to study at Northampton College, and particularly what type of skills and knowledge that students develop with us, plus how that type of skills and knowledge prepares students for their next steps into perhaps some further study, employment, or even an apprenticeship. You'll also hear from our colleagues about the range and type of support that we provide to our students. If you do decide to take up one of our construction courses. Hopefully at the bottom of the screen you can see a little Q&A icon. That's at the bottom of the screen, so that's an opportunity for attendees to ask our expert panelists questions as we go through the presentation. There'll also be an opportunity for question and answer at the end of the presentations, and we'll be able to explore lots of your queries, your questions that come up as a result of some of the input from our panellists. So that's the plan for the next hour. So hopefully the technology will hold up. We've done two of these recently, and they've all gone to plan with technology, so hopefully today we know different. So if I hand over to my colleagues, can we play the introduction, please?
Welcome to our first virtual open event. My name is Pat Brennan Barrett, and I'm the principal of Northampton College.
And I'm Patrick Levy, and I'm the deputy principal at Northampton College.
And we hope that we're going to be able to give you the information that you need to make your choice. But before we move on to that, I'd like to talk to you about the pandemic and the preparations that we're making to make you safe at the college. So we've taken very good heed of the government advice, and we've gone further. We've mapped every part of our college, all the rooms. We're looking to find a footfall reduction of 50%. We will make sure that there is social distancing in all of the classrooms. We will have zoned areas, and we will have sanitizers and PPE. This is very important for your safety, and you will be expected to change your behavior, but we'll help you to do that. We know how important it is for you to feel safe coming to college. We have made significant investments in technology through cameras and laptops, and we are moving very much towards the digital age, but you will spend significant amounts of time in college. And as we go through this presentation, I hope that all of your questions will be answered. And Mr. Levy will talk again about our COVID response some way through the presentation. So I'd like to direct you now to our presentation. We are one of the leading colleges in the country. We're actually now seventh for the National League Tables for the 16 to 18 curriculum. So that's significantly improved over years. And this is down to our students and our staff and how we work with students. We're also ranked 13th and 18th for English and Maths, and fourth for ESOL. We want to make sure that you're in a college that can give you the very best. So we are a good college with outstanding features. We've got very, very good confidence in our delivery, and we know that we can get you to be the best you can be, set your expectations high, and help you to achieve them. So 96% of our students have passed their qualification last year. We expect that to be higher this year, even with the challenges of the pandemic. So together with a very outstanding environment and a culture of very high expectations, you'll be immersed in a state-of-the-art building. All of our buildings are state-of-the-art, both at Daventry, Booth Lane and Lower Mounts. 94% of our students go on to further education, work or apprenticeships. That's a very high number progressing towards their goals. We aspire to support a generation of students who believe that they can make a difference. Look at the challenge and find a solution. Succeed in changing the world. Embrace modern technologies. Build new companies and create new jobs not yet imagined, especially now when we need you most.
So now I'm going to take you through some of the specific areas of study within the college. Every student in the college is an individual, and the programmes are essentially made up of a main qualification for students who need maths. There will be maths study, English for effective communication, digital skills to help you in the digital world, where appropriate and safe, work experience will be offered. All students will have individualised targets, and you'll have tutorials to support you through your progress. We offer qualifications at a full range of levels, from foundation and entry level right through to level 5. Where you start within the college depends on your prior attainment and the qualifications that you come to us with, but there is an opportunity for every applicant. The college prides itself on how supportive it is to its students. We're very conscious of providing wraparound care. So a student will get a timetable and will not just be expected to attend face-to-face lessons and perhaps online lessons, but also to embrace the wraparound care that supports their learning. As previously mentioned, we're very conscious of providing a safe educational environment, and our response to the COVID pandemic has been to really interrogate how we make the environment safe, how we produce a blended learning delivery model that is safe and will secure progression for all students. Social distancing, hygiene and protective equipment will all be very important for students coming to this college. I mentioned wraparound support, and that support is critical to help students in their progress. Lessons will be interactive through various digital platforms. A wide range of online learning resources will be made available, and all students will have help to develop their digital skills to ensure that they can capitalise on the learning opportunities here at Northampton College. We will provide support for providing students with the equipment and the resources that they need to ensure that they do well on their programmes of study. Our expectations are very high. The college has a very good reputation. That reputation is built upon good habits for students, habits that develop excellent punctuality, excellent attendance to all lessons, dedication and positive engagement, high aspiration to achieve the best possible grades within programmes, and we provide a very effective monitoring and tracking process to ensure students know the progress they are making. Our journey to outstanding. We endeavour to be the best college in the community, putting our students at the heart of everything we do. We're constantly evolving and challenging ourselves. We're building a college to meet the needs of future generations. And to meet the needs of an environmentally sustainable society. Join us on our journey to outstanding and unlock your potential.
Okay, thank you, Pat. So, I hope you found that useful. Just a quick update and an overview of the college. Just a reminder about the question and answer icon at the bottom of your screen. Keep the questions coming as we go through some of the information from the panelists, and as I say, there'll be an opportunity for some additional Q&A at the end. So just like you to hand over to my colleague who's the assistant principal for STEM, Jane Deary.
Hello and welcome everybody. My name is Jane Deary and I'm the Assistant Principal for Science, Technology, Engineering and Manufacturing, which includes the construction area that we're talking about today. Within construction, there are several different courses that you may be interested in. They're on the slide that you see in front of you. So you might be interested in carpentry, joinery and theatre film set design, painting, decorating and interior design, electrical installation, plumbing and heating, brickwork and hard landscaping, multi-skills, or maybe civil engineering. I'd like to now introduce a virtual tour, which includes our wonderful new advanced construction engineering building, which is a real asset to the college, and hopefully you all enjoy the tour. I'm sure you'll agree our facilities are excellent and impressive, and hopefully enjoyed your tour. I'm now going to introduce you to Mark Bradshaw, who's our curriculum manager for construction and electrical installation, and he will give you a little bit more detail about those courses. Thank you.
Thank you, Jane. So our courses consist of carpentry, plumbing, painting, plastering, brickwork, multi-skills, civil engineering and electrical. All of my team are qualified in their trade and have got experience of working in the industry all around the world. They all have got a lot of experience working in education as well. So moving on, our construction courses, you don't just come to become a carpenter, electrical, you gain so many more skills while studying with us. Some of the example units that cover all of the courses: principles of building construction, information and communication. So you're learning more about the construction industry. Health and safety is very important. So you learn early on about health and safety within construction. Majority of our courses, they cover access equipment and using them safely, how to maintain them and store and erect them correctly. You also learn how to use and maintain hand and power tools. And the structure of the construction industry, you need to know where you're going to progress to, what you're going to progress to in the future, maybe site manager, civil engineer, whatever you decide. So on the next slide, you come to Northampton College to do a study program. You're not just going to learn the skills to become a carpenter. you're or a plumber. You're going to be doing so much more. So the practical skills you're learning, our brand new aid centre, they're realistic to industry. We work closely with industry to make sure that you're learning relevant skills. We assess you continuously, supporting you, encouraging you to really progress your skills whilst at Northampton College. We work with local area as well, developing resources for local schools, railways, anything to get that work experience whilst working at college. You have a tutorial as well. This includes British values, prevent and safeguarding, and employability skills. We develop your employability skills whilst at Northampton College. And you'll start with quite a small CV, and by the end of your time with us at Northampton College, that will be extensive with loads of new skills and experiences. You do English and maths. Even if you've achieved your English and maths, we have our maths and English lab, developing knowledge further. And if you need support on your course, you support with either maths questions or assignments. And then we support you as well with further study, going on to different courses with us, higher education, or apprenticeships, or full-time employment. One thing we're really proud of within construction at Northampton College is the further enrichment that we give you. We have Women in Construction Week, celebrating with own women and women in the wider construction area of how good it is to have a diverse construction sector. We have a trade show where we invite industry partners in, show off the new tools within industry and give you the experience to see what it's like to speak to them. We offer CSES cards to certain students. CSES card is really important to get on site, and we've been the opportunity to give a large amount of our students one of these.
Hello.
We have guest speakers from industry, loads of guest speakers developing your knowledge further to progress to. And we, one thing I'm really proud of, our support of a local DIY SOS project where our students worked on one of their builds. So now I'm just going to introduce some of my team. They've created short videos to talk about our courses a bit further.
I'm Jackie. I teach on foundation and level one multi-skills at Northampton College. I'm based at Booth Lane and Daventry campuses. I teach mostly theory, so I look at things like health and safety, some structure work, and I also teach employability on the foundation course. So we will be looking at things like getting you a good CV, some interview skills, working in a team, all the things that are really, really important for a career in construction. We'll also do some community project work, so things like helping a local primary school build some resources for their forest school area, and anything that you might be interested in, we could potentially have a look at. So if you've got any ideas, you can let me know and we'll see what we can do. I also have experience teaching students with SEN, so I can help anyone that has an additional need or a learning difficulty, anything like that, any reason why you might find it a little bit more challenging at college, I can try and help you with that. There's lots and lots of support in college for everyone. We've got additional support department who are brilliant and can help you both outside and inside the class. The library staff are really, really good, and the maths and English labs really good if you need a little bit of one-on-one extra support in those areas. As part of your multi-skills course, you'll also do lots and lots of practical work. So you'll be possibly taking lessons in plastering, plumbing, carpentry, bricklaying, painting and decorating, or electrical. So you'll get a really, really good chance to experience a little bit of everything, see what interests you, and then that will help you decide what you want to do for progression. So from a foundation course, you should be able to gain the qualifications needed to progress to a level one, and then you can pick what you want to specialise in. So you'll quickly learn which bits you enjoy, which bits you really don't, and that's fine, that's part of the course. And we just ask that you give it your best shot, you try your hardest, and that will help you succeed and move on. I will see you all in September. Looking forward to seeing you soon. Thanks.
Hi, my name's Simon. I'm a lecturer in carpentry and multi-skills here at Northampton College. I left school at 16. I did an apprenticeship in carpentry and joinery. I then went on to study for an HND and then went on to degree level. I've got many years of site experience and have been teaching in a variety of schools and colleges for the last 18 years. I'm here today to talk to you about our multi-skills programme and the opportunities that this qualification may bring to you. The qualification you will be studying for is the City and Guilds Construction Skills 6219. You will complete a variety of units of work in carpentry, brickwork, plastering, plumbing, electrical, and painting and decorating. We're serious about getting your career kickstarted into the construction industry. The multi-skills course is a fast-paced environment, easy access, which will give the individual an opportunity to study in a variety of trade areas to find out which one suits them. Our multi-skills team are here to help you every step of the way to give you the skills, confidence and ambition to have a long and successful and lucrative career in the construction industry. Check us out and hopefully we'll see you in September.
Hello, my name is Alan. I'm a brickwork lecturer at Northampton College, based at Booth Lane. I have 34 years experience, 22 years of this based on site. I started as an apprentice and trained to be a fully fledged bricklayer. I've then progressed on to being a site foreman and eventually a site manager. I've also been on site as an apprentice master for a large construction company, where my role was to train their apprentices to become bricklayers. For level one, it's a basic bricklaying course. You start with recognising the tools, learning to use the tools, then you'll build walls with brick, block, cavity walling and some setting out. There's also an element of landscaping, so you'll be laying in slate, some slabs, block pavers, some edgings and some concrete. Primarily, it is a practical course, but there are elements of theory that you need to complete. There are 6 assessments in theory, 4 assessments in practical. For level 2, primarily it is the same, but technically more difficult. You'll need to build walls which are solid walling, attached piers, isolated piers, cavity walling with openings, and brick arches, which are either segmental or full arch. One of the best routes is to get an apprenticeship, taking the skills you've learnt from the college into the workplace. For 4 days you'll be in the workplace and 1 day you're in college, and the best, you get paid for doing it. You can become a site manager, a contracts manager, building inspector, an HB inspector, hey, and you might even want to be a lecturer 1 day yourselves.
Hi there, my name's Andy Harper and I'm the plastering teacher here at Northampton College. I've been in the plastering trade for 35 years, starting at 17 as an apprentice, working with my dad for a Bedford building company, and attending Luton College. While an apprentice and also as a qualified tradesman, I've worked on all sorts of jobs, from brand new houses, commercial work, heritage and restoration work, with basic walls and floors, exterior finishes, specialist granite work, all manner of stuff. Training-wise, I've been teaching in further education for 27 years, a majority of the time in offender learning, but more recently here at Northampton College, which is a fantastic place to work and to learn. Basically, I enjoy passing on my trade and a trade that I love to other people. The plastering craft is a wide and varied subject, not as some people have you believe, just a matter of spreading a bit of material at the wall. When learned properly and in depth, it encompasses all manner of interesting work. You'll be able to plaster new houses and extensions, take on small patching and skim jobs. You could specialise in ornamental fibrous work, heritage line work, floor screening contracts, or do a little bit of everything. As I say, making it a really interesting, fulfilling job to be in and a great craft to master. Of course, the more skilled you are, the more employable you become. And of course, That means the more money you earn. When you begin with a level one qual, you will learn about various backgrounds and how to correctly prepare them for various plastering applications. You'll be shown how to use and care for tools of the trade and be coached and guided through to the stage where you can float and skim a wall to a smooth finish, and also be able to tack and skim various studwork backgrounds. The level two will, amongst other things, give you the ability to screed floors, apply various external finishes, including pebble dash, ashlar, monocouche, etc. You'll understand and be able to install dry lining systems and even produce ornamental plaster work.
Hello, my name is Paul Bailey and I work for Northampton College as a teacher in construction. And the main qualification that I teach is the BTEC National Construction and the Built Environment in Civil Engineering. Now I'm just going to start with just a little bit about myself and my experience. I had an apprenticeship at 16 as a bricklayer, and I qualified my level 3 in bricklaying back in the late 1970s. So I then went and had several years experience as a bricklayer before going on to become a site manager, where I run sites and I also was involved in the civil engineering aspect of those sites. So I was involved with foundations, drainage, roads, car parks and associated works such as steel frames. What is this qualification that I'm talking to you about? It's a level 3 course. Over 2 years, it's equivalent to 3 A-levels. So a lot of it is expected. It's a theory-based course, not a craft-based course. What do we teach on the BTEC National in Civil Engineering? We look at construction principles, construction design, tendering and estimating, construction technology, health and safety in construction, surveying, graphical detailing, management of a construction project, further mathematics in construction, and construction and civil engineering. So they're just a few of the units that will be covered.
Hello everybody, my name is Tim Chisholm. I'm part of the Carpentry team here in the ACE Centre at Northampton College, and put together a short video explaining the courses that we can offer.
Here we focus on site carpentry. At level one, it is all about gaining solid basic skills, learning the new language and terminology, learning about hand tools, portable power tools, materials and the wider construction industry. The level one diploma focuses on construction projects at a bench, learning a range of jointing techniques and hand skills. You will improve your accuracy over the first year, starting out with comfortable tolerances in the early stages, with the aim to being exact at the end of the year. The natural progression would be to level two. Here you will focus on the requirements for working on site, first and second fixed units, looking at structural and hidden timbers, and then finishing timbers visible when the work is complete. At the end of this course, you could look for work in the industry, as this is a recognised qualification to start your career as a carpenter. Level three is an option to progress to after level two. A good understanding of geometrical and curved works will be needed. You'll be looking at theory from a more supervisory position than being an operative. We aim to teach in a way that will prepare you for the construction environment, taught by qualified teachers who have many years' experience in the industry. This is not school, it is an industrial training and preparation for a career in a great industry.
Thank you. Hello, I'm Jan Phillips, and I teach on the painting and decorating course within the construction department. I've always had a big passion for painting, decorating and interior design, and I've been involved in some big commercial projects from conference centres, wedding venues and individual properties. I've always combined my love of decorating with teaching in schools and colleges. So within our City and Guilds qualification, we deliver a range of units from working at height. So we assemble mobile towers, being able to understand the health and safety aspects of this. This contributes to great teamwork within the group. We also do a unit that works with different surfaces, preparing them, understanding them from timbers, metals and plasterboards. We look at applying and working with a variety of paints, and this in turn will give you an understanding of colour, mixing and room schemes. We look at all aspects of wallpapering. And then there's a unit on theatre effects. And as a painter and decorator, this will give you another string to your bow when you could specialise in doing stage sets. So you'll be able to make a piece of cardboard look like a fence or a shed or a marble pillar that's made from cardboard. So we do some specialist paint effects as well. Throughout the year, we work on a number of external commissions and jobs that are needed in both the local and the wider community. This gives us time frames and deadlines to work with. Right, so I'll be with you every step of the way to encourage your enthusiasm to work and pursue the skills and the techniques you need to become a painter and decorator. Whether you progress onto an apprentice or level two or a higher level, we look forward to really welcoming you in September. Thank you very much.
Hello, my name is John Kendrick and I'm a plumbing and heating lecturer at Northampton College. I've been teaching for approximately 5 years now. Before I came into teaching, I worked in the industry as a plumbing and heating and gas engineer for approximately 18 years. At Northampton College, we deliver both Level 1 and Level 2 full-time plumbing qualifications in addition to the NVQ2 Intermediate Apprenticeship in Plumbing. The course gives students the opportunity to develop the hand skills, accuracy and understanding needed to work with a variety of common plumbing materials such as copper and plastic pipework. In addition, the students will be given training on on-site safety and safe systems of work in order to better prepare them for the world of work. Theory elements of the Level 1 course cover areas such as health and safety, basic copper pipework and plastic pipework systems, and an introduction to simple hot and cold systems in domestic properties. On the Level 2 course, students will extend their skills to begin working with more real-life installations, such as hanging and piping at radiator systems, planning and fitting toilets and basins, completing a full air and cover installation with hot water cylinder, until their final task of planning and fitting a full bathroom suite. Level 2 students will be taught about a range of domestic hot and cold water systems, above and below ground drainage systems, methods of central heating, including fault finding and maintenance, and Level 2 students are expected to demonstrate a thorough commitment to the course, including self-study and homework tasks. I hope that's given you a good overview of the plumbing courses offered here at Northampton College, and I look forward to seeing you in September.
Hi, and welcome to Northampton College Construction Team, specifically the electrical team. My name's Rob Windsor, course coordinator for Level 2 and tutor across all courses. Your course here at Northampton College will be split 50-50 between theory and practical sessions. Your theory units will be assessed in the way of either a handwritten assessment or a multiple choice online exam. The practical assessment will be assessed by no fewer than two people to give you a fair result. The team here at Northampton College come from all parts of industry. We bring a huge wealth of knowledge and experience together in helping you achieve your highest grade possible. All courses cover domestic, commercial, and industrial installations. You will be taught different methods, different applications, and test and inspection once those installations are complete. You will also energise your installations to show that everything works, it's functioning correctly, and there are no faults present. The qualification that you will obtain here at the college is a City and Guilds qualification. That is recognised the world over, and that's exactly what you can do. You can go and see the world with your qualification, work in any corner of the world with it. So come along, sign up, make the most of this, and we'll see you in September.
Thank you to Mark and the construction team for that very informative overview. I'd like to now run through some really terrific previous student feedback with you on this current slide. So if we start in the pink, I really enjoy the course. My tutors are really supportive and the facilities are amazing. I hope to go gain a degree in civil engineering and work in project management. The next one, the tutors at college have been fantastic. They help me step by step and are very friendly and motivational. It's a great college to be at. And then the final bit, I really enjoyed my work experience placement. It's a great opportunity to put what I'm learning at college into practice in the workplace. We'll now move on to our life-changing video.
Taking pages from a magazine, been looking for the answers ever since we were 17. You know the truth can be a weapon to fight this world of ill intentions. A new answer to the same question: how many times will you learn the same lesson?
Move on to our live question and answer, and I'll hand it over to Alex.
Thank you very much, Jane. My name's Alex. I work in the marketing department at Northampton College. Throughout the whole event, we've had a few questions coming through on the Q&A, so we're going to try and answer as many as we can in the time we've got. So the very first question is from someone called Amy, who's asked, am I eligible for financial support? So I'm just going to direct that question to Lizette Ellis from our Futures team.
Hello. So yeah, you can apply for a bursary. It is eligible. Anybody that has household income of less than £26,000 a year can apply. If it's just over, we would recommend applying anyway, just to see what help, if any, that we can offer you. And that can involve costs for your bus pass and to get to college, for any equipment that you need, any trips that you may go on, or anything like that. So yeah, you can apply, and that's all going to be on the website as well. So if you just go to the tab that says students or support for students, sorry, on the website, and you can find out all the details on there.
Fantastic, thank you very much. I've got a question here about apprenticeships. What's the difference between a carpentry apprenticeship and a full-time course? I'm just going to direct that question to Lizette again, because, oh no, sorry, Yvette's here. Yvette, would you mind answering that question for me? What's the difference between a carpentry apprenticeship and a full-time course? Oh, sorry, you're still on mute, Yvette.
Sorry, people. Essentially, it's the same qualification. Previously, that would have been a day release program, but obviously moving forward, that may be something that we need to address. However, it is a two-year program. You would need to have a place of employment, which we can assist you with through our vacancy and recruitment team. And they're the best people to start with in your inquiry, and they can be reached on 01684 734 323.
Fantastic, thanks very much, Yvette. I've got another question for Lizette from our futures team. Someone anonymous has asked, are there any extracurricular activities at college that I can add to my CV?
So yes, we do lots of extracurricular activities, and they vary, but obviously going forward, we are still doing them, but we're not quite sure how it's going to look in the current climate. But we do. We've had teams in all sorts of different sports. You can do. There's lots of different things that you can try if you want to learn how to play a certain instrument, or you want to join a group. There's lots and lots of different things that you can do, and they're all on our system when you join into the college. What you need to do is go onto our Moodle site, and you can just book onto all of the different ones that you want to, obviously making sure they don't clash with your timetable. We also take requests as well. So if there's something that you specifically want to do, you can request that we have a look into it for you, and we will, my colleague Gavin and Rob, they will both look into it for you and see whether we can get that set up for you.
Fantastic, thanks very much, Lizette. I've got a quick question about maths and English. Apart from maths and English, is science a compulsory subject that also requires a grade 9 to 4? Phil, would you be able to take that question for me, or possibly Anne?
I think Anne, if you can answer that one for me, please.
Is science a, can I just clarify the question? Is science a compulsory subject for?
It just says, apart from maths and English, is science a compulsory subject that also requires a grade 9 to 4? So I'm assuming that's to get onto any of the full-time courses.
Right, no, to get onto any full-time course, science would not be a requirement. For some courses, maybe in the science area, it might have been specified as a need, but I would say that it's very unlikely that it's specified against the courses that we're talking about this afternoon.
Fantastic, thanks very much, Anne. A question here from Timothy asking, can I do a level 2 in plumbing without doing the level 1? Mark, could you take that question for me, please?
Cool, thank you, Alex. It's based on your entry requirements. So again, if you look at our website, each course has an entry requirement. If you have the maths and English, you can generally move on to a level 2 course. So it'd be well worth looking at our website for all construction courses to see what entry requirements. And if you've got it, you can come straight into a level 2.
Fantastic. Thanks very much. Mark is our curriculum manager for construction in the built environment. So while I've still got you, Mark, I've got another question. Have you had many female students take part in your construction courses?
Yeah, the numbers have gone up massively over the 2 years that we've been doing construction at Northampton College. Last year we've had one, and in our paint department alone we've had 6 females. So yeah, it's definitely seeing a change.
Fantastic. And do you do any, have you had any sort of specific events or anything targeted at females recently?
We had our Women in Construction Week that I'm incredibly proud of, where we had women can come in to speak to our students. We had taster days, we spoke for the event, and it was a real success. It was really, really good to celebrate women in industry and our own women in construction.
Fantastic. Thanks very much, Mark. I've got another maths and English question here. Oh, sorry, maths question. Someone said that they're not very confident with maths. How can the college help them pass their GCSE? Anne, Assistant Principal for Maths and English. Can you take that, please?
Hello. Well, we try at the college to always make the subjects that we're teaching relevant to the area that you're coming from. So we will be able to apply the maths skills that that we're teaching you to areas of construction to help make it more relevant and meaningful. And often this will help you to understand and grasp the maths more easily. We have very small groups. So we are looking at teaching you in groups of just 10 next year. We will be able to provide you with lots of additional support for maths. If you are able to do more, then we will be able to meet with specialists on a one-to-one to do some extra in our additional learning support team. And we'll also, as part of your learning, be giving you access to a very impressive software system that enables you to work and practice some of the skills that you might be finding difficult.
Fantastic, thanks very much, Anne. I've got a question here for Angela from our additional learning support team. An attendee has asked, can I get additional support with my dyslexia?
Yes, within the additional learning department in the college, we've got a dyslexia team. And depending on what kind of support the student needs, they can organise weekly sessions, whether it be small groups or one-to-one support. If you've got any concerns or questions, for now, if I could ask you to contact the CENCOR, Helen Janska, and her number is 01604 734 184, and she would put you in contact with the right person in our team. Thanks.
Lovely. Thanks very much, Angela. Phil, who's our vice principal, I've got a question for you from someone called Maisie. She's asked, would you be doing any taster days this year before college due to the pandemic?
Thank you, Alex. Hello, Maisie. So we are looking at the current situation very closely. We are planning to start after the summer break. And if there is an opportunity to operate safely within a window over the summer for tasters, that's certainly something that we are looking at very closely. It is something that we would do under normal circumstances, but we will take the advice from the government very seriously and work with that guidance.
Brilliant, thanks very much, Phil. I've got another question for Lizette again. I'm not sure if university is the best destination for me after college. What other options are there?
So part of my role within the futures team is to discuss the future. So that could be essentially anything. You could go into work, you could look into you could go to university. We could look at why you're not thinking maybe university is right for you, because a lot of people think that it's not because of certain aspects which we can go through. We can look through apprenticeships. You look into further sort of progression within the college or within other colleges, whatever is sort of the right route for you. So we would go through, have a conversation with you, and look at all the options and which ones are the right ones for you. There's lots and lots of different options though. Don't worry, there's lots.
Lovely, thanks, Lizette. Do you have to start plumbing at level 2 or can I join straight on to a level 3 course? I think that's another question for Mark.
So similar to the previous question, it's based on requirements, and really for any level 3 trade course we do look at having a level 2 prior to that, because there's so many units that cross over to the level 3. So it'd be very rare that someone would come straight onto a level 3 trade course.
Okay, thank you very much. I've got a question here as well about painting and decorating. Could I become a self-employed painter and decorator after completing a level 3 course?
You could do. There's no reason why you couldn't, but it might be a good idea to gain a bit more experience within industry, working for various employers, before you take the jump to become self-employed. But there's no reason why you couldn't.
Lovely, thank you very much. Sorry, another construction one, Mark. I'm keeping you on the line for a while. I'm not confident in my practical skills, but I'm really interested in construction. Is the college still for me?
So if you've got the grades, it might be worth looking at our civil engineering course, where it's mainly assignment and exam based. There's still practical elements, but it's more the surveying. There's maths involved, there's CAD, so computer-aided design and drawing. So it's a different sort of practical. So again, if you've got the entry requirements, that might be the course for you.
Fantastic. Thank you very much. I've also got a question here about additional sessions to help with GCSE maths and English. Anne, do we run anything like that at the college?
Additional sessions?
Yes, to help with GCSE maths and English.
We have a maths lab and an English lab, which are currently drop-in centres where you would be able to go and call in between lessons to have individual support from an English or maths specialist. We also always have additional lessons on offer during the holidays periods for anybody who would like to come along. And we have our additional learning support team that can provide specialist support with maths and English to help you with those tricky bits that you're finding. Of course, with the situation that we find ourselves in, we are going to have to manage these places a little bit differently so that we manage them within our social distancing policies. But we will still be offering lots and lots and lots of extra help for maths and English at Northampton College.
Brilliant. Just to follow on from that question, we've also had someone asking, what exam board does the college use for maths and English? For example, AQA, EdExcel, OCR, etc.
For maths, we are using EdExcel, and for English, we use AQA.
Brilliant. Thank you very much. Okay, another question about electrical installation. Is it difficult to learn the skills required for electrical installation? And Roberto, do you mind if I pass that question to you?
Yeah, okay. Hello, everybody. No, it's not difficult, but the important is you need to attend a college 95% punctuality, and we give you all the tools and support that you need. But no, the onus is on the candidate. So we can teach you exactly what you need to know, but you need to attend the college on time and 96% attendance.
Brilliant. Thanks very much, Roberto. Another question based around sort of industry. Is it easier to achieve a career in industry if I do an apprenticeship, or is it easier to do a full-time course? I don't know if Yvette's there because I can't see her picture. So, Lizette, would you mind taking that one? Is it easier to achieve a career in industry with an apprenticeship or a full-time course? Oh, Yvette's there, sorry.
Yvette's there, yeah.
Hi, Yvette. Sorry, I think you're still on mute.
Hi. Sorry, could you just repeat it so I'm clear on my answer?
Yeah, no problem. So, is it easier to achieve a career in industry if I do an apprenticeship, or is it easier to do a full-time course?
You couldn't answer that in a black and white fashion. It would depend on the learner and the employer that they're with. In my opinion, the apprenticeship will give you the edge because you have work-based learning. You are not at college full time. You are on site, and you're learning those skills in a far faster fashion.
I don't know whether
Roberto wants to add to that.
Yeah, I can add to that. A full-time course starts at level one, level two, or level three. So it's 3 years course, but you still need to become a qualified electrician. You still need to have an apprenticeship for 1 year. So it's better start the course to become a qualified electrician having an apprenticeship rather than full-time. Full-time is 3.5 days a week, and an apprenticeship is 1 day a week, and the other days you go to work. So the best route is really start with an apprenticeship, but you can still do the 3 years learning full-time, and then you, it's a bridger, you can move over to the apprenticeship, finding a job on the fourth year, and then you become a qualified electrician. So you still have to work on the fourth year.
Brilliant.
I do think you do need to understand, as an apprentice, you are working full-time, you are attending your college, and you do need to obviously maintain your attendance, keep up with your work and so on and so forth. So it is a balance and you do need to be committed.
Brilliant, thank you very much. I think I've just got time for one more question. I'm looking at becoming an electrician and I've applied for the course. Would I be able to buy my own tools and use them? I don't know if that's better for Mark or Phil to answer that one. Mark, yeah?
We have got a really good range of tools. We really invest, we work closely with industry. So there's really no need with our workshop to bring in your tools, but we've got equipment. And like I said, we work with industry to make sure we're using the best kit. So I would say no, we wouldn't generally stop you, but then it'd be your responsibility to look after your tools. Really, there's no need.
Okay, brilliant. Thank you very much. I think that's all we've got time for today. So thank you so much to everyone who's asked questions. If there is anything that we haven't answered or maybe you think of something later today, you can pop onto our website and we actually have an online chat so you can talk to someone on there and they'll be able to help you. I'm just going to pass back to Phil O'Hara, who's our Vice Principal, for a final few words.
Okay, thank you, Alex. And thank you to all our participants, our panellists, and some really interesting questions from our attendees today. And hopefully that's been, some information that we've provided today has been, really informative and will help you to make the right choice when you're thinking about your future careers in possibly some area of construction. And as we come out of the current situation that we're in, construction is a really good place to be, a vibrant area of employment. There are projects that will be happening in and around the county, such as HS2, house building projects and infrastructure projects. So there is a wealth of employment opportunities in the construction area as we go through. So some real opportunities to get the training that you need to make a career in construction. So hopefully the information that you've got today has been useful. If you do have any further inquiries, we have our email address. It's inquiries@northamptoncollege.ac.uk. So drop us an email and we'll come back to you with any information that we haven't covered today. You'll also get a link to this presentation. So if you've missed anything, you'll get an opportunity to re-watch that. And if you go along to our website and make an application fairly quickly, then we'll make sure that application is fast-tracked through so you can secure your place for after the summer. So that's it for this event. We hope you've found it useful and you've got what you need to make your informed choices. So thank you very much for your time today. Enjoy the rest of your day and stay safe. Thank you.